One of the most common things we get asked is how do we invite an external user to participate in a SharePoint site? Now, sharing in SharePoint is really, really simple. There's usually when you see a file or a folder, you can hover over it and click share. I'll just quickly show you what I mean. So here we've got our general site. If I want to share this, I can just sort of hover over there. This is in a document library. Type their email address, hit put a message in there and hit invite, right? It's that easy. There's nothing more really to do it to be able to share. You can change settings, etc., on who has access, etc. If it's an external person, make sure you choose the last one. Incidentally, if the anyone link is grayed out like it is here, it's because the SharePoint site hasn't been given that privilege. Now, by default, that's the setting. You can actually go into the admin center and change this, so ask your administrator to change that should you need to. So we can pick on files and folders and share away, and in you go. All you have to do is verify that you own that email address and you're in. Anyone links don't even need to verify. Okay, but what if you want to invite them to the group proper, meaning all the apps and services and this entire page and everything that's on here? Well, that's a little bit more difficult. You see that there's a share button up here, but that's only sharing the page. That's not going to help you. That's like sharing a file. We need to invite them as a member to this group. And when we click on up here to go group membership, we go add members, but if you start typing their email address, it's not going to work. If you read up here, it says to add external guests, go to Outlook to invite others. And why are we inviting them via Outlook? Well, the thing is behind every SharePoint site, or especially for behind every SharePoint site is an email group, right? So we need to invite them into that email group to give them access. Now, I wish Microsoft would make this a little bit more seamless and didn't have to go through this, but we're not there yet. So when we get into this area, you can see more information about the group, and you'll notice it's got an email address associated with that, right? So you can actually email this group. Now, there's a few things you need to enable to allow that to happen. You actually have to allow, so when we go into edit group, we actually need to change a few settings to say let people outside the organization email this, right? And we can change the name of it and all those sorts of things. However, how do we get someone external? All we need to do is go add members and then type their email address. Type it right. And you'll see immediately it comes up and says, hey, this looks like an email address. Do you want to add them? And it's indicating here that it's a guest. So I'm going to say, yes, that's what I want to do. I'm going to go add. Of course, it's going to do that to me. So if we go across into, so they should receive an email address very, very shortly. Sometimes it doesn't do it the first time. So just to be 100% certain, I'm going to add them again. Because we did get that little error. Okay, one member successfully added. That's what we wanted to see. And you can put in multiple members, etc. So I'm going to go view all members. And you'll see that member isn't there yet. And it does take a little while for it to update in the back end, right? And what we can do is we can come across into here, into the admin center, and we can go to guest users. Right, what you'll see is there's that guest user, and we've got this funny email address. You know, it's the email address of the person X'd at your tenant address, which is that on Microsoft one. If I click in here, I can actually change contact details, like you can change the display name, for example, and job title and all that sort of stuff to better provide some information around that. The other thing is we should be able to check to see which group is in here. Now, for some reason, it didn't actually add me this to this group, but that's because I haven't accepted the invitation. So I'll just refresh, see if it hasn't updated. Ah, there we go. It's now updated. It's added me to the guest site. Across here in my email, I just got a notification from sysadmin. That's the account I'm logged into. So if I click on this, and it's going to give me information about this site. So it's going to give me more details. That's the site for that particular event. I can email this group. I can go to SharePoint, etc. So, and I can also go to the shared notebook, and you can remember that, right? So you can save this to get back to it later. If I click on here to go to SharePoint, it's going to log me in. All right, I'm already logged in as a guest user. Now, if you haven't accessed this tenant before, it'll come up with a little notification of saying, I need special permissions. You know those ones when you connect an app and you get the thing to say allow or decline? Well, I've accepted those permissions for this particular tenant before on this account, so it just logs me in. It's using my Microsoft personal account, not my business account. So if someone's got a business account, same sort of process will happen, but it will be against this particular tenant. So if they have a Microsoft business account or a Microsoft personal account, they'll log in. Easy as. Don't need special passwords or any of that thing to be able to get access to this. But what happens if they don't have a Microsoft account? How do I gain access? Well, that's pretty easy because we've seen this workflow happen before when you share a file. When you share a file with someone that doesn't have a, that, you know, to get access, it doesn't use this login process. It actually asks for an email verification. How that works is it says, just verify that you have your email. And it sends a 7-digit code, not the 6-digit codes, to your email address that you copy and paste into the box on the screen, and you're in. And it authenticates you, no problems. So that works really well for Google people. And the same experience is going to happen here for those Googlers or people who don't have maybe an Apple ID account, etc. It will just send them an email with a code that they can be able to log in. They just have to verify their address. That's it. All the other experiences that you would get as a guest within the environment, I can see there's a OneNote notebook in here that I can gain access to as a guest, yes, up here, andy.prosser@outlook.com. That's not the business address, right? So then I can go back here. I can close this. Come on, I did say close, didn't I? I'll go back here to this site. I've got those files there. I can come into here. I can create a new folder. I'm going to make it a green one and go and create, right? So I can create that particular item. Now, if I get rid of this and I come back to our site, I'm just going to refresh this page and you'll see that it's starting to make some changes. It does take a little while for it to update this, so don't stress if it doesn't get through. It's got some synchronization stuff that comes through, but it will update. I can see Teams, which is available in this site, but ironically, it was actually listed in the other one. I can come across here into Documents, and I can see that one that was created by this guest user. So anything that a normal user can do, a guest can do, pretty much. And which is another interesting thing, how do I actually interact with Teams? Now, if you use the desktop app, right, it's going to force it to log out of yours and switch into the new one. However, there's a workaround. And this is sort of a bonus little aspect here. So I'm going to say, no, I'm going to cancel that. I'm going to use the web app instead. So I'm logged in using the web browser. I'm going to sign in using my web app. So I'm just going to quickly grab the credentials. Oops. Log in as this. And now it's going to say I need certain more permissions to be able to get access to this thing. This is the screen I was saying earlier that you'll get if it doesn't know. So I'm going to say accept. It already knows who I am. I don't need my password. It already knows that I have a guest account in there. And it's going to give me access to Teams. Now, Teams does take a little while to load in a browser, but you get the point. I can actually interact with this. So if you are invited to another organization's team site, etc. And you don't really want to deal with the login, log out, and switch contacts, and you get all these messages, just open it up in a browser instead. Create yourself a new profile and stick everything in there and be happy. So there is our guest site as a team. That's pretty much all there is to it. So I hope you found that useful. Just remember, when you have a guest and you want to invite a guest to a site, it's through this member option here. And we want to add members and then go to Outlook to do it. That's the key here. If you do that and you follow the steps, you'll be enjoying collaborating with your peers, both internally and externally, in no time. I hope you found that useful. Till next time, bye for now.